Keeping It Real. Today we have Franco with us, and we're going to ask him a whole big bunch of questions, and we're going to get some really good answers. Hi, Franco.
Hi, how are you?
Good, good. Tell me about the streets. We're in Niagara Falls, so.
Well, the streets of Niagara Falls is pretty much like all the other streets. Mm-hmm. It may happen at a slower pace, might be less people, mm-hmm. but you still have the crime rate. It's on every corner, from guns, drugs, and just kids. You know, basically what I hate to see on the blocks first thing in the morning is, I know you're supposed to be in school.
Yeah.
I know you should have been in class somewhere, but
that's
you out
true.
Here, you know, like, mm-hmm. this is my 9 to 5, this is, and you don't even know nothing yet.
Yeah.
You know, so a lot of them end up with shorter lives with that thinking. So
that's true.
The streets is, it got our babies, it do. And that's why we need more leaders, you know, out here other than with a car or big jewelry saying, this is how I lead, this is what you need, you
mm-hmm.
know, so
mm-hmm.
the perception off top is just wrong.
Now, what do you think, you know, I was at a meeting this past week,
mm-hmm.
and they were talking about, well, we need funding, you know,
mm-hmm.
we need
mm-hmm.
funding to do this,
mm-hmm.
and great people, but I think, like, for me, it was like, well, you know, funding is good,
mm-hmm.
funding is good, but, and we're going to need that down the road,
mm-hmm.
but what do you feel could be done right away with people that don't have any funding? Like, how can we reach the people on the street to give them hope?
Well, I say one area is that's always good is to just have a getaway for them, like something that they know is going to be open at least maybe once a week. Somebody, somewhere they can go where they know they can share whatever their problems is or whatever's happening going on in their life. They got to have a place first where they can turn to. So many of them say down the road, I never had this person there.
That's
or
true.
This avenue wasn't available. You got, they need that one little avenue right away so they can't, so it, they can maybe just say, maybe. They got to
yeah.
have that start first.
So if they know that someone cares about them and they can go and maybe share, would that be it? Would it be like a group session? Or
yes.
Something
yes.
like that? That
it,
would help.
It has to be something to where they know they're going to be heard. Because a lot of them don't get heard in the household. You know what I mean? They don't go to school enough to, you know, be heard
that's
by the teacher
true.
Or whatever. So just somewhere where they feel like, I know one person cares.
Mm-hmm.
And then that'll open up another door to understanding that there's a higher power. So it starts with just some, because we got to lead. Even though when we say it ain't no hope, or I'm just tired of dealing with these kids and it ain't going to change.
I know.
Somebody got to stand there still and say, I'm going to the end with it.
That's true. Now, what age do you feel this all starts at?
This is anywhere from your adolescent years right up into your teen years.
Yeah.
You know, those are those years where you tender at, and a lot of us think we're grown.
Yeah.
At 16, 17, 18, we got the answers. And ain't even in school, but we got all the answers. So that tender age there is where I say our leaders need to focus on our youth more at.
So if we started groups, I know there's Lexi's Place, where that's a group run by
mm-hmm.
Brett Biro
mm-hmm.
that for kids that have tried to commit suicide, they have cut themselves.
Mm-hmm.
They're maybe off the drugs now, but they still have a lot of
mm-hmm.
emotional problems because they've been abused and
mm-hmm.
stuff like that. Now there's that group going on in town, but we need more groups then.
Yes,
we need
do.
More.
We do. We just
yeah.
gotta have it. It just come down to caring and about what. You know, some folks just care about every day. If I can make more money than I made yesterday, if I can get this move to this place and have this better house by my way, they don't care who get trampled on, stumped
no.
on, and those, you know, in that path. It's just about them. You need more people that still old fashioned. Everybody too new school for me. Everybody is so into everything that started to me from 2000 to the current. Nobody's old fashioned. That's why I say I'm glad that I'm a 70s baby, because I still got the old fashioned ways and morals and believe
yeah.
in it, because
yeah.
a lot of the kids now out here, their parents was born maybe 20, 25, 30 years ago, so they doing what
that's
their kids
true.
Doing.
That's true. That's
you
true.
You know, you got
yeah.
grandmothers out here, 24, great-grandmothers, 40, that's...
That's true. That's true.
Man,
and
that's,
they're smoking with the kids.
Yeah,
they're teaching the kids how to smoke.
Yeah, and then you condoning it, basically.
Yeah,
so you
exactly.
can't say what they ain't or what they is doing when they ain't around you. You knowing it. You
yeah.
do it with them.
Yeah, that's so true. That's so true. So how would I, like, say we got a group together and
mm-hmm.
we go out to the streets and we say to some of the youth on the corner, okay, look, we got this going on. Would you come would you come? Would they listen to us or would they laugh at us?
I say yeah, because one thing that always attracts that kind of attention, that clientele, is you get to speak. You don't have to sit there and, you know, like
that's
a class.
True.
Most youth don't like to sit in a class setting and feel like, you know, they got to give undivided attention. They like to be mobile,
that's true.
You know, so
that's true.
You get to speak.
Yeah.
Whoever's in charge there, our staff, whichever one you feel most comfortable with, mm-hmm. or, you know, whatever suits you, just come in there. It's all about peace.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And going forward.
Yeah.
You come in, you're welcome to speak, but, you know, it's not somewhere where you just come in to do what you're doing now.
Exactly.
You know, so.
Yeah. So
absolutely.
It makes a difference. So if we need a building then.
Yes, we would.
Because, you know, mm-hmm. Maybe a church setting. Now, I know some churches in town mm-hmm. that might give us use of their gym or something like that,
okay.
you know, where we could meet.
Mm-hmm.
But would the kids on the street, the teens and stuff like that, say that are dealing, say
mm-hmm.
some of these
mm-hmm.
that are dealing, would they come into a church setting or should it be a, you know what I mean?
I know
because
what you mean.
Automatically
I know what you
it's
mean.
Like,
that,
ah,
that
God.
Church, yeah,
you know what I mean?
They get scared when they hear the word
yeah.
church. Yeah,
yeah.
They get to think.
And
about,
I don't blame them.
Yeah,
I don't
you know,
blame them.
Yeah.
Because it's,
The message to them, though, you know, is clear. It's
mm-hmm.
about help. It ain't really about, you know, what you're wearing. We're
yeah.
trying to help your decision making, you know, whether it's in a church, a gym. If I just pull up to you on the corner, the message is just, is the same.
Mm-hmm.
You know, forget where we at. The message is what I'm trying to get to you. And still at the end, it's come down to them. They might come one time, didn't like something
yeah.
rubbed them the wrong way, and then, you know, they could go out and badmouth us, or, you know, or they
yeah.
could even send more people, say, well, let me go see, I might can get me something out of this, whatever. So
yeah,
just something to be there. We ain't gonna get everybody, but maybe just even one they say is enough.
Exactly.
So if
exactly.
we can get one,
yeah,
everybody ain't gonna be welcome to it, and they're gonna see another way to shoot it down. You might find graffiti or something. It's always
mm-hmm.
gonna be that little devilish acts in the beginning when
yeah.
you're trying to get something like that off the
and
ground.
Yet some of the graffiti is beautiful.
It is. They just
you know what I mean? They
put
need
it.
A place to paint. They
yeah.
need a building just to paint.
There you go.
Because they got talent.
Yeah.
I mean, that is talent.
Yes,
and,
it is.
You know, it's like what I would like to do is see their talent nurtured.
Hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Where
mm-hmm.
they can
mm-hmm.
Say, well, I can paint. Let me paint.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
here,
mm-hmm.
here's a couple of walls. Go ahead and paint. Do
mm-hmm.
whatever you want. You know, they may be some, you know, keep it clean, kind
yeah.
of, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But let them
yeah.
get motivated to see that they do have talent.
Yes.
You
and,
know,
and
they do
don't
have
get no other way to display it other than that way where,
exactly.
you know, and I'd be like, well, that should be one example to yourself that you have this talent. Why not say, you know what, I'm going to go see what course
mm-hmm.
or what college may be offering some that could help assist me with this.
Yeah.
Whatever. But then again, there's that little corner they thinking, I got to go to a classroom. I got to
yeah.
slow things down. I can't do it when I want to do it. Now there's a schedule. I have to go to school.
I know.
And then they find those as obstacles, and you never really get going.
Well, you know, when I went to school, I hated it.
Yeah.
Like, the teachers
mm-hmm.
were crazy. One
yeah.
teacher had dandruff. Honestly.
Yeah.
And what did he do? Stand at right behind my back and scratch his head, and it
ooh.
Fell like snow.
Yeah.
You know, and I thought, what am I doing sitting here? In high school, trying to learn when I
yeah.
got some man
mm-hmm.
that has a dandruff problem. You know what I mean? And it was like, oh my God. So I can understand
yeah.
how the kids would feel this way.
Yeah.
You know, because it
yeah.
is confining, and a lot of them have had problems with ADHD and,
yeah.
you know, emotional problems too. So I can understand where they can't
and
be
yeah,
confining.
And it's almost
you know?
Like another little pressure point for them.
Yeah.
Now they're feeling like every little thing they do is scrutinized. Now I've got to
yeah.
hand in paperwork.
Exactly.
And closely examined, you know, so that allowed them, I'll
yeah.
do it later or
yeah.
I'll get back to it. But those are things that, you know, that stagnate all races from all cultures, that those things, that pressure, and don't know if they can do it when, like the saying goes, whatever you want to do, you can do it. Just do it.
Exactly. Now, what if, like this show is called Keeping It Real.
Mm-hmm.
What if we start to spread the word and
okay.
say, okay, you want to voice your opinion. You
mm-hmm.
you meet. We'll meet somewhere. I will interview you. You can have half hour if you want. Or, you know, something like that. You can speak your mind and say, listen, this is what's going on. Do you think that would help the kids?
Yes, because it's appealing right away. As you see, how quickly you got me over here. You said you get a chance to say a little something. And right away, I was like, okay, next week, I'm on for it. You know, and sometimes that is something to grab, especially if you like me that want to be heard and you know that you got some words that can be impactful.
Well, I think, and you know, Franco, I really think that is one of the things. So many people have lots to say, and I think that's why God, and I bring God into it, because for me, I never knew how to write a book. I never knew anything about cameras or anything, and about 4 or 5 years ago, you know, I really felt led to write a book. You know, and now, like, if you want to write your story, and this is what I want to tell the people out there, if you have a story that you want to put in a book, I will help you do it. I can do them. You got to do all the writing and the typing and stuff like that, and give it to me, and I'll have your book in about a week. It'll be all done in about a week, and then within the month, you'll have a copy in your hand. So it's like, I think maybe some of the youth that don't feel, you know, maybe their whole life they've been getting condemned. You know, maybe mom and daddy's like, well, you're no good. You're never going to amount to anything. So they feel that. So then their way out is to go to the streets.
Absolutely.
And then they feel cool. I you know, I have met some that feel really cool because they call themselves a thug.
Right.
And it's like, well, you know, that's okay. I just got a letter from a girl. And she's going to write a book. She's done 22 years in prison. She went in at 18, 19 years old because she killed her pimp. She just shot him. And she says, I didn't realize it would be the rest of my life in prison. And so she wrote me yesterday and she says, Ann, could I write a book to the youth? Because she says they're out there and they don't understand that one action with a gun or a knife or something like that, that could be their whole life. And you know, the way the system is today, it's, you know, you might go thinking you're getting 3 years and you got 30. Because this is how it works.
Easily. And it's just terrible, the choices they make on split seconds. You know, and I tell them the biggest way to manage that is lower the risk. You know what I mean? You can't put yourself in high-risk situations all day and expect to win. One of them times, it's going to catch up. Unfortunately, to some of us, it's the graveyard. And as you're speaking, it won't hurt some penitentiary.
Exactly.
So you got to have two better results than that.
Exactly.
I mean, it's got to be, you know. But the more this social media picks up and the more we can't reach the youth and the more the streets are raising our children, and these predators are just walking around praying, waiting to attack through Facebook or Twitter, whatever it is. The more we allow those things to bloom, those devices, and the more it seems like we're going to get out of reach with our children. And it's just terrible that these things are just grooming them, and they hook right on it. They can't even go to sleep on time, can't get up on time for school because they up all night.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I saw some this morning. I was waiting on the porch to get a ride here, and some guys were, you know, going in their house. And I smiled because I was there at one time. I was there, you know, coming home at 7 o'clock in the morning, ready to crash, but then figured, well, you know, I'll do a little bit more before I crash, you know. And so I kind of looked at these guys, and I thought, oh, man, like, your life is going by real quick, and you know, you think it's cool right now, but really you're searching inside. I know I always had that emptiness inside that I was searching for, and I know most of the people are, and you know, I thought, Lord, we got to do something to reach them, you know. So would you be willing to be like on a board and
oh, absolutely,
yeah, we'll try to get something going
without question. I've always said, if that's the least that we can do now, because after all, if that is an actual fact, they are the future.
Yeah.
I believe. Sing it with me, people. I believe. Oh, sing it out loud. I believe. Sing it a whole lot loud.